Why is my table full of cassette tapes? That's because I just got this at the thrift store. It's a laser line AC100. Holds 100 cassette tapes. Got it for $4. And I just screwed it into my lattice wall here, so it's ready to start holding some tapes. It's not enough to hold all my cassettes. You can see I have quite a bit more here. And I have more in this compartment here, but I did manage to clear out three of my cassette tape cabinets so I can free up some counter space for other stuff. Still looking for an 8-track holder because I have started a little bit of a collection of them. It'd be nice to have something to put them in, but these are all my home recordings I did over the years, including in here as well. So I have at least 100, if not more, of my own recorded tapes. So the rack on the wall is just going to be for the commercially pre-recorded tapes. About a quarter of these I bought when they were new in the late 90s. I bought my last new cassette in early 2000, which was this one, Westlife's US album, which came out in April 2000. And that was the last new cassette I bought. And the first new CD I bought was in 1999, so it was only about a year transition when I switched from cassettes to CDs. In fact, I have it right here. The first new CD I ever bought was Keith Urban's US debut album from 1999. So all these are going to go into that rack on the wall. I do have a couple of really old tapes. You can see these were before they standardized on the regular clamshell design that everybody knows. This one, this tape just slides in the side. This one is just a cardboard holder like they used later for cassette singles, but this is a full album. Although unlike a cassingle, it's not just a tape stuck into the cardboard, it comes in a holder. And the cassette is orange. I think that looks really cool. You can tell how old it is because it says compatible stereo cassette, and it's by Superscope, which I believe at the time was importing Sony equipment into the US. And this is an older style clamshell design where it's all black plastic. Some of these don't even have a year on them. Maybe 1973. That's my guess for this one. And I do have one old cassette, which is the all plastic clamshell design. But this one is actually too wide to fit into these slots. So that's not going to go into this rack. I'll have to store it separately. And here's the most interesting style cassette tape case I've come across. It's an old Memrex tape. And it opens like that. So while I'm rendering video on my MacBook, and yes, that is a fan to keep it cool, I'm in the process of sorting the tapes. Got all the albums alphabetized. And here are the greatest hits cassettes. I just have to go through the compilation cassettes. Now it's all sorted and ready to go on the rack. That ended up working perfectly because I had a total of 101 commercially pre-recorded cassettes, but one of them, as I showed, wasn't able to fit in that rack because it's too big to fit into the slot. So that left me with exactly 100 commercially pre-recorded cassettes to fit perfectly into this rack. Now I'm thinking of getting another one of these, putting on this side of the light, and using it for my own home recorded cassettes and cassettes that other people recorded that I came across over the years. Because I have just about 100 of these combined with all these and the ones in this drawer here. These three cabinets are now empty, so I can donate these to the thrift store. So I'll get another one of those 100 cassette racks, and then I'll put these two next to it. These are two side by side, and I've measured it, and I would have just enough room to put another one of these 100 cassette racks on this side of the light, and then those two smaller racks on top of each other over here. And this thing that holds my modem and router, I can cut that down shorter so it won't get in the way of the cassette racks. Here's another pile I have, including some thrift store finds of really old radio recordings, such as WPIX-FM from New York, recorded January 31st, 1974, in stereo. So this is the oldest recording of FM stereo I've ever heard, and it sounds good still. So that's a historic recording of early FM radio from New York City, and the tape still plays absolutely fine. So it's over 40 years old, and the cassette is perfect. I also have this rack here, which I actually made a video about, but I never uploaded it because I didn't think enough people would be interested in it. It's a rack for 8mm video cassettes, such as Hi8 or Digital8 recordings. You can get these on Amazon.com and various other places. It's made by a company called Bryco, and I'll actually need to get another one of these to fit all my 8mm tapes, as you can see. So this is no match for Ray Glasser's wall of Betamax. I think he has over 1,000 Betamax tapes, if not even more than that. And I may actually be getting rid of some of these tapes if I have them on CD or vinyl, because I don't really need these albums on duplicate formats. So maybe donating some of these to the thrift store eventually. And I don't really plan on getting any more cassettes unless I come across something really interesting and unique. But it's nice to have these organized in a way that's easy to reach, and that looks nice when it's displayed like this on the wall.
WPIX-FM, Stereo 102 with Jim Quinn, y'all. At 7-Eleven in New York. Hello, Fred. How you doing? Hey, boy, they're really taking that beer thing seriously over in Brooklyn, you know. They're closing down a brewery over there, and they're dumping 103,000 barrels of beer into the sewer. Can you believe that? I rode through Brooklyn today, right? It was a guy in Flatbush Avenue standing over a manhole covered with a straw.
Hey, good news for 16 and 17-year-olds who would like to be driving this summer. Adelphi Academy is now accepting students for its spring semester driver education program. It begins February 20th. That's February 20th. Courses are held Monday through Saturday from 7 a.m. until 5 p.m. Adelphi teaches you on its new 1974 dual-controlled safety cars, including the sporty Javelin. Adelphi has the only foolproof method for parallel parking. And listen to this.
Jim Quinn, nonstop. Music.
I got it from Marianne from 83rd Street in Brooklyn. Hi to Stephen and Richie and Cindy from Parsippany, New Jersey. Marianne and Richard from Brooklyn. Turtles!
Some girls like to run away.